Today's video, we got a tutorial for you, kind of like an updated one. I did a video like months and months ago on Verus coin and mining it with CPU, but I've noticed there's been a lot of comments that saying like it does work, people are having issues, this and that, and things have kind of changed and updated since that last video. So I figured just to do a refresher and remake it. Obviously, since Verus has also had quite the run, it's up to like $5 or $7. That's Canadian, obviously. I also look at American price, but I mainly, when I'm mining and all that, obviously I stick to Canadian just so I can convert it with my bills and hydro and things like that. But for today's video, this tutorial is going to be showing you how to mine it with CPU and GPU just in 2024 here, just to kind of give you guys a refresher, what software to use, what pools to use, because things have changed. Obviously, sometimes pools and stuff shut down or people have issues. Last time I showed you how to do it on a phone and everything. I can still do an updated part on that, but I just kind of want to stick to CPU and GPU as I got rid of like kind of my phone mining setup. So I really don't have access to like some of the phones, and some of them are just kind of dead, or they're just like not working anymore. But again, this tutorial here is going to be for CPU and GPU. Verus coin is a lot better mining with CPU compared to GPU. So if you are wanting to mine it, I would recommend mining with just CPU. But if you do have like maybe a couple extra cards, or the CPU rig you're using has some GPUs with it, you can go ahead and just use the whole rig itself. Only certain mining software does work when it comes to Verus. There's very limited amounts, and it just depends on your software as well. We'll be going over all that in today's video. As you see here, I just have the website up, so if you guys do want to go check it out and you get an understanding for Verus coin and what it's doing and a reason why it's pumping or this or that, there's a whole breakdown of what it's used for and their technology behind it. Obviously, it's just to do with the market conditions as well. A lot of things are just pumping and going right now, obviously due to just the bull run, and you have Trump in the US. He's really endorsing crypto and stuff like that. So there's a lot of positives when it comes to crypto. So if you do want a wallet for it, they do have their own wallet here. So they have the desktop version now out. They have it on mobile as well. They have a CLI, depending on if you prefer to use that on command line. We will go ahead and download the Verus desktop. I have not like been personally mining it or anything for Verus coin. I don't even have a wallet anymore. I kind of lost it in the transition of moving my phones around and upgrading my phones. So unfortunately, I did have Verus coin before this whole pump started, but I've kind of lost access to that, unfortunately, unless I'm able to recover it somehow or just find it on one of my other phones. But yeah, for now, we will just download a desktop version. So all I do is click download Verus desktop. And then depending on your operating system here, obviously I'm using Windows here, as you could tell, but if you're using Linux or Mac, you can go ahead and download it. But we'll just download the Windows version here. And once that's done downloading, we'll go through the whole setup process here. So as we see, it is just downloading, and we'll just let that finish up here. So once it is downloaded, you go to wherever it is downloaded. You can extract it here. So all you want to do is click extract to, and then if you decide to put it to your desktop, downloads, whatever, I'll just go to my downloads because that's where it is. You just let it extract depending on the software you use here. We close that out. We'll go to downloads. It will extract to a folder here, or it'll just be right in its like two files. So we'll open up the folder here. You might just see it like this within your directory, depending how you extracted it. All you want to do is run it here, and we'll give it a minute to boot up. It's obviously going to say that because it's an unknown publisher and everything, just like all things with mining and running like software, like mining software, wallets and all that. It's just not signed technology, like the app itself is not signed. So it's going to say, oh, it's a virus, this or that one. Really, it's not. So I just click I agree. You install it here. You just click next, next, next. And then we'll just let this install here, and then I will continue the video here. So once it gets through that install process here, it's just going to come up with run Verus desktop. So we'll do that right quick here. Then we'll see, like I said, this is my first time running the software and everything. So we're going to see together how this all runs and operates. Obviously, I have an understanding of wallets and Verus and all that because I used to use the mobile version. I mined it on my mobile phones and then had one of the phones with the wallet on it. So like I said, if I do find that, then I have some Verus coin and I made a little bit of money with the recent pump here. So once it opens up here, you're obviously going to create like a wallet or profile. We'll just quickly put that in here. And then the profile is created, and then we click select. And then you can have all these options. There's mining dashboards, so you can check out like the whole mining network and atmosphere, Verus IDs, manage your own verifiable, privacy maintaining, secure Verus identities. Or you just want to go to your wallet, of course, here. And as you see here, your wallet's already set up. I don't think you really need to like set up a whole private key or anything because it's ran through the account. We will see here. Like I said, it's still new to me. So yeah, they have a, you can add multiple coins here. So if you do want to mine other coins, they have a whole list you can go through, but our focus obviously Verus. You hit continue, and then you can choose a light mode or download the full blockchain, which is a native mode. We will just do native, which is like the full blockchain. You click add coin, and now it's just going to download. It looks like the required tools to sync to the blockchain and obviously the whole blockchain itself. So we'll let that do its thing. And in the meantime here, I just kind of want to show you. Now, mind you, this is Canadian price because that's what I usually deal in. So this is CAD, I believe. But as you see here, I was mining it kind of back here a few months back. I did make some videos on it. But now, as you see, the recent price pump, obviously with the whole crypto network, but obviously something has happened to trigger this big price increase when it comes to Verus coin and everything. Like I said, there's a lot of coins that have some solid technology. That's why I've mentioned Flux and Zealous and all these other ones, because there's obviously something new and better always coming out. But Verus has been around for a while, but now obviously the price pumps happened, and I figured just to follow up with the video and obviously to do with my comments and stuff, just to give you guys a refresher on everything. But we'll go back here and see where it's at. It's at 80%, so we'll just kind of let it, I'll pause the video for now. Once this is at 100%, we'll see what to do from there. So during that process here, it came up with an option. Would you like to speed up the syncing to the Verus blockchain by downloading blockchain data from the internet? I'm just gonna click yes. So as we see here, it's already syncing, it's all going. So obviously you have to let it synchronize and catch up to the blockchain, but then you'll be good. So I'm just gonna allow this through. So as you see, it's downloading the whole blockchain and all that. Right here is gonna be your wallet, receive. We'll do public, I guess. Obviously, you might not be able to create one right now just due to the fact it's not synced up. I'm going to pause it and let it fully sync up here so that way you guys can fully see how to properly do this. But I'm just going to pause it here and then let this fully sync up, and then we'll get back to it. Alrighty, so once it's all synced up, it will say wallet connected and it'll be 100% here. So all you do is for transparent balance, because that's private balance, I'm not sure the difference, but you'll click receive, public, and your address should be right there. So all you have to do is click copy, and that's going to be your mining address. So you're probably wondering like what software you use for mining. That will be SRB Miner. I found that kind of works the best with Verus, and from what I'm reading online, that seems to be the typical one. So all you want to do is click download on their website here, and then click download from GitHub, and it will redirect you here to their SRB GitHub. And all you do is scroll down a bit to assets. And as you see, there's a bunch of different versions, obviously depending on your operating system, you click the corresponding one, but I'm going to do Windows, obviously. So you let that download. So once it's downloaded, it may say it's suspicious, obviously, just because it is a mining software. All you do is click download suspicious file. Windows might pick up on it as well, so you might have to disable your antivirus for like a quick minute. Yeah, as we see there, it kind of picked it up. So all you have to do is click on that. And then you want to go to manage settings under virus and threat protections. To get to this normally, all you do is click your start menu and click settings. And then all you want to do is come down to update and security. And then you go down to Windows security here, and it'll bring you to like the same window. You click virus and threat protection, and it'll bring you here. Click manage settings. You turn off real-time protection for that short period of time. And all you want to do is just quickly re-download it. So you go here, Windows, and it should download just fine. It'll block it again. You click download suspicious file and it should successfully download. So all you do is go to where you downloaded it. So I download it here. You right click, you click extract to, and then the folder name. Then once it's extracted, you'll see it here wherever you did download it. And then from here, what you wanna do so you can turn your real-time protection back on is scroll down to exclusions, add or remove an exclusion, click yes on the pop-up, click add an exclusion, add folder, and then you go to wherever you downloaded it. So here, SRB Miner, and then you want to click the actual folder itself here. And then all you do is click select folder, and that should redirect it. So that way that will be avoided with that, just because it's not a registered software with Windows, it detects it as a virus. So all you do is click turn back on, you click yes on the pop-up, and then you come back to your folder here, and then you're gonna have all your different options here. So what you want to do is scroll down to start mining Verus coin, and it should be a bat file. You click edit with whatever software. I'll use Notepad++ here. And as you see here, it's going to have your algorithm and everything. You can enable the GPU, so you can delete that command here and it should be fine. You may have to put enable GPU, but we'll see here as we try it out. So your wallet address here, you just want to go here, copy it from the software, and then you're just going to paste that right there. And then for the pool, I have a couple different ones to use here. You can go on mining pool stats and get a wide variety so you can see where all the hash rate is. It's good to kind of balance it out so that way it's not all on one pool, kind of how it is now. So watt pool might be an option for you. Click that and it'll open up the Verus pool here. And all you want to do is click connect. And then depending what you are using, CPU, GPU, or farm, you select the corresponding one. And then you'll just set it up how it says down here. So you would take the stratum URL and then you would paste the stratum URL just like so. You click copy. And then you go pool, and then you go right here and paste it in. But this pool seems to be like dependent on CPU or GPU. If you want a better pool, and my recommendation is using viper.net. I use this for Zealous, as you've seen in my last video. So once you're on the homepage here, you find a Verus coin, you click start mining, and it's going to give you a bunch of different locations and stuff. I'm going to use the Canadian one here. You click copy. And then as you see, it has a few different ones. So all you do is click copy the stratum and port. I don't think you need the stratum plus TCP for SRB miner here. So all you would do is go here and then you would paste it in just like that. And then that should allow you to start mining with SRB miner. All you do is click save or file save, depending on the software you're using to edit. And then you close that out and then you go here and it should start up. It's going to say it's protecting. You just click run anyways. So we'll see, I am recording. So as you see, it detected GPU and CPU. I don't know if it's also running the GPU as well. It says they're both enabled, so we'll see if it's kind of running both, because it does pick up the RTX 3050, which I do have in here. But again, I don't know if it's actually mining with the CPU or GPU right now. Okay, as you see, GPU result accepted, accepted. And then it should also be running on the CPU as well. So you'll kind of be doing like the dual mining. So we'll see here. Yeah, there's a CPU as well. So yes, you have both up and running if you are using this kind of setup. Oh, let me pull that back up. Obviously, just depends. If you are using hiveos, it might be a bit different of a setup. I'm just showing you on the Windows way here because it's a little easier. And if you are using like a smaller forum rig, you can do the CPU and GPU setup here. So if you are on hiveos, it'll kind of be the same setup. I will just kind of close this out for now. But as you see, it's accepting both CPU and GPU through viper.net. Viper.net. And then all you do is paste in your wallet address for Verus right up top here. So you copy it again from the wallet and you can search it here and it should come up. It might take a few minutes, obviously, because the shares are just getting accepted and everything like that. You can go back to the home page, paste it in, click search. And as you see here, it brings it up and it'll tell you once it does get up and rolling. It just takes a few minutes to actually get going. But yeah, that's it for the Windows part here. So I'll just close this one out. I just kind of want to show you guys that. And then I don't know if I have my hiveos open here. We'll quickly just open it up here. So it should be similar here. You just go to open up your hiveos, go to flight sheets. And then all you would do is coin ticker. And then you would do Verus, I think, if they have that. Yeah, they are. Forgot, it's VRSC. And then you would add your wallet in. So all you do is copy it in, you add it in like that, Verus, you click create, you select pool, viper.net most likely, because I said it's easier, and then you would select your corresponding location, so I'll just choose Canada, you click apply, and then the miner is SRB miner, like I said, is kind of the better one. You can go ahead and use CC miner, but it has to be a certain version. I recommend using SRB, because that way it works with AMD and it also works with NVIDIA as well. And you click setup miner config to make sure it's all set up. Just make sure you don't have like disabled GPU or CPU. If you just want to use your CPU, you put in disable GPU. But then if you just want to use GPUs, you put in disable CPU. So that way it just focuses on whichever mining software or mining way that you do want to set it up. So that way it just focuses on CPU or GPU depending what you're doing. If you want to run both, you just leave that part blank there and click apply changes. And then you just give the name like Verus Mining. and then you let that, and then you click create flight sheet, and it will create a flight sheet, and then you just launch that on your workers here. And it should work just the same way, just like it did on the Windows version here. I know I kind of did this hiveos one pretty fast, but I'm trying to make this video a little shorter because I did rant on at the beginning and stuff. But I just wanted to show you guys both ways, mainly with Windows, because my old video was with Windows and mobile devices. But like I said, I really don't have any mobile devices to mine on right now. So right now I'm just doing it strictly for CPU and GPU. If you guys want me to, I will try to find like a phone or tablet or something, and I can do a follow-up video for a mobile mining. But your best bet with difficulty and stuff on the rise for Verus, as we see here, you can see the difficulty and stuff is really growing compared to what it used to be. So it might not even be worth it on mobile anymore. It just depends on the device and how many cores and stuff like that, like we broke down in the old video. So if you do want to take a look for the mobile way, you can check out my old video on Verus coin, and then that way you can kind of go from there. That'll give you a base idea of what to do. But personally, I'd recommend CPU and GPU, mainly CPU, just because that's what this coin is really built for, is CPU. GPU might not be as profitable, but if you just want to run everything and try to build up some Verus, why not go for it? Just depends on your power, you know, the wattage, things like that. But yeah, hopefully this video brought some information to you guys if you were looking to mine Verus, or kind of like a follow-up of what pools to use, because I know some people are having issues. And obviously it depends on your CPU and GPUs, just like any other coin. It might not work for you, you might get errors. Try different mining software if you need to. Like I said, I just recommend using SRB and then using the Verus wallet, the official one here, not any third-party ones, because they did just recently put this out. You can use the mobile version as well on like Android and stuff.